Israel will stand against the forces of barbarism until victory. I hope and pray that civilized nations everywhere will back this fight. Because Israel's fight is your fight. Because if Hamas and Iran's axis of evil win, you will be their next target. Israel did not start this war. Israel did not want this war, but Israel will win this war. Hamas launched this war by perpetrating the worst savagery our people have seen since the Holocaust. Hamas murdered children in front of their parents, murdered parents in front of their children. They burned people alive. They raped women. They beheaded men. They tortured Holocaust survivors. They kidnapped babies. They committed the most horrific crimes imaginable. And they're part of the axis of evil that Iran has formed, an axis of terror that works by arming, training, and financing Hamas in Gaza, Hezbollah in Lebanon, the Houthis in Yemen, and other terror proxies throughout the Middle East and beyond the Middle East. In fighting Hamas and the Iranian axis of terror, Israel is fighting the enemies of civilization itself. Victory over these enemies begins with moral clarity. It begins with knowing the difference between good and evil, between right and wrong. It means making a moral distinction between the deliberate murder of the innocent and the unintentional casualties that accompany every legitimate war, even the most just war. Hamas will continue to use the basements in Gaza's hospitals as the command posts of its vast terror tunnel network. It will continue to use mosques as fortified military positions and weapon depots. It will continue to steal fuel and humanitarian assistance from UN facilities. While Israel is doing everything to get Palestinian civilians out of harm's way, Hamas is doing everything to keep Palestinian civilians in harm's way. Israel urges Palestinian civilians to leave the areas of armed conflict, while Hamas prevents those civilians from leaving those areas at gunpoint. Hamas is also preventing foreign nationals from leaving Gaza altogether. And most despicably, Hamas is holding over 200 Israeli hostages, including 33 children, holding them, terrorizing them, keeping them as hostages. I want to make clear Israel's position regarding a ceasefire. Israel will not agree to a cessation of hostilities with Hamas after the horrific attacks of October 7th. Calls for a ceasefire are calls for Israel to surrender to Hamas, to surrender to terrorism, to surrender to barbarism. That will not happen. Thank you.
Viral jurnalis Rumania melakukan kebohongan saat melaporkan perang Hamas dan Israel. Pasalnya, sang reporter mengaku sedang berlindung dari serangan militan Hamas. Namun sebaliknya, ia berada di tempat yang aman lantaran terlihat orang berseliweran di belakangnya. Adapun video tersebut telah beredar di media sosial. Wanita berkaus merah muda itu sedang tiarap dan berada di balik mobil putih. Ia pun sedang melaporkan perkembangan terkini perang Israel-Hamas. Dalam laporannya, ia mengaku bersembunyi untuk berlindung dari serangan militan Palestina. Sang jurnalis pun menampilkan rasa ketakutannya terhadap situasi konflik. Namun pada kenyataannya, jurnalis wanita itu tidak berada di tengah ketegangan perang. Sebaliknya, ia berada di lingkungan aman lantaran banyak warga Israel yang berjalan dan bersepeda tanpa rasa takut. Sontak video yang viral ini langsung menuai kecaman dari berbagai pihak. Banyak orang yang menyebut aksi jurnalis itu sebagai propaganda. Bahkan jurnalis yang tak diketahui namanya itu disebut sebagai ratu drama lantaran melaporkan berita palsu dan dibuat-buat.
Those children that died, lying. We understand that you're a news channel. You have your power and policy, but where's your humanity?
Did you know that Israel is paying influencers on social media $1,000 a video to put out reports about Hamas being evil and savage and beheading babies and doing all this shit and defending Israel's right to defend themselves in this genocide? $1,000 a video. They're paying influencers to promote their fucking genocide. First of all, shame on any of you fucking influencers who took the bait and the money and did this. Shame on you. You are complicit in the genocide of a people. Second of all, shame on fucking Israel. You know what? I would expect nothing less, since you're just a vassal state of the United States who does the same fucking thing. It's always about controlling the narrative, and it's always about putting the propaganda out there to justify the horrific fucking things you do to other people in the world. Just like the fucking United States does. It's disgusting. And as a United States citizen, I'm going to continue to fight against my own country doing it, and I'm going to continue to fight against Israel doing it. This is horrific.
I'm a Palestinian Christian who stands unequivocally, hand in hand, arm in arm, and side by side with my Palestinian Muslim sisters and brothers. But I am here to remind the world that Palestinian Christians exist. Of the 14 million Palestinians in existence, the majority of whom are in refugee camps, in diaspora, and pretty much scattered and have been scattered all over the world for 75 years, there are approximately 3.5 million Palestinian Christians, and we exist. And we are also being slaughtered in Gaza. There is a minority of Palestinian Christians in Gaza that are being murdered by Israel. So I have one question for the Christians all over the world who stand with Israel. How dare you? Free Palestine.
Hello guys, I'm a Christian Palestinian from Gaza. I still have family who live there. I have my grandparents, I have my uncles, I have the people, my friends that I grew up with. I lived there for 15 years. I experienced 3 wars in my life. All we ask for is our land back. This is not about religion. We're Christians. There's Christians in Gaza. There's Muslims, Christians. This is not about any religion. This is about humanity. You gotta speak up. What's happening is a genocide. This is the worst war that I have ever seen in my whole life. I've experienced so many wars, but this is the worst one that I have 16 people. We can't reach them out. They don't have electricity, they don't have internet, nothing. We have not got a hold of our family for the past 24 hours. You guys gotta speak up. Boycott Starbucks, boycott Disney, boycott McDonald's, because this money is going to kill our people. They're killing our innocent children, innocent mothers, innocent dads. You gotta speak up. You can't stay quiet about this genocide.
Karma dibayar kontan, guys. Inilah yang terjadi kalau orang-orang satu dunia secara simultan memboikot produk-produk yang berpartisipasi dalam pendanaan perang Israel dan juga mensupport Israel. Seperti yang teman-teman tahu, kejahatan perang Israel ini sudah diambang batas karena sudah menjatuhkan bom ke rumah sakit dan juga anak-anak dan juga sipil. Sehingga warga seluruh dunia, bukan hanya yang muslim, juga berhenti memakai produk-produk seperti dari Unilever, Johnson & Johnson, kemudian Starbucks yang sudah terang-terangan dan juga McDonald's yang bahkan di Amerika sempat mengganti bungkusnya dengan warna biru putih yang notabene merupakan warna bendera Israel. Akibatnya apa? Efek dari boykot ini udah terlihat ya dari harga-harga saham per tanggal 27 kemarin, karena sekarang kan weekend. Jadi kalau teman-teman buka nih di Google, nih lihat dari Nestle, Johnson & Johnson, dan sebagainya, nah itu semua sudah mengalami penurunan yang signifikan karena orang-orang di seluruh dunia stand with Palestine. Ingat, ini masalah kemanusiaan, bukan masalah agama. Banyak juga di Palestine orang Kristen dan Yahudi yang juga terbunuh karena mereka juga civilians di sana. Dan Israel tidak hanya melawan Hamas, mereka melawan sipil.
Kata siapa ajakan boikot itu nggak ngaruh? Sini-sini, buka mata lebar-lebar ya. Kita tonton bersama-sama, kita mulai dari perusahaan yang emang terang-terangan memberikan support kepada Israel. MC. Dikutip dari Merdeka.com, saham MC langsung anjlok usai beri bantuan makanan ke tentara Israel. Mari kita cek saham MC per hari ini, tanggal 29 Oktober 2023, turun 0,027%. Kalau dihitung 5 hari kebelakang, turun 0,33%. Ditarik mundur lagi, fluktuasi selama 1 bulan berapa? Turun 2,92%. Turun 2,92% itu bukan sedikit loh, gede. Dengan nilai kapitalisasi pasar senilai 186 miliar US dollar, maka jika dihitung-hitung, mereka itu rugi sebesar 5,4 miliar dollar atau setara 80 triliun rupiah. Entah ini benar atau enggak, silahkan yang ngerti dunia saham bisa dikoreksi jika saya salah. Lalu apakah cuma saham MC aja? Yuk kita cek juga perusahaan-perusahaan lain, kayak Johnson & Johnson Amerika. Per hari ini anjlok 2,28%. Perusahaan HP atau Hewlett Packard anjlok 1,26%. Saham Puma anjlok 0,68%. Perusahaan Danone anjlok 1,83%. Walt Disney anjlok 0,56%. Unilever anjlok 1,88%. Nestle anjlok 1,44%. Starbucks anjlok 0,70%. Coca-Cola anjlok 0,97%. Netflix anjlok 0,41%. Hampir semua fluktuasi saham perusahaan-perusahaan pendukung Israel pada anjlok. Apalagi kalau bukan efek dari boikot massal masif di seluruh dunia termasuk Indonesia. Lalu, mari kita lihat saham beberapa perusahaan lokal dan internasional yang tidak memberikan bantuan kepada Israel. PT Indo Jakarta naik 0,75%. PT Mayor Jakarta Barat naik 1,52%. Fumakil Jepang naik 0,48%. WIG Surabaya naik 2,29%. Dari sini kita bisa simpulkan, meskipun kita bukan ahli ekonomi, tapi kita bisa melihat di atas kertas betapa ngefeknya seruan BDS, boikot, divestasi, dan sanksi untuk produk-produk pendukung Zionis. Jangan dikira nggak ngaruh.
Dalam
beberapa negara di dunia melakukan demonstrasi untuk memberikan dukungan ke Palestina. Tak hanya di negara Timur Tengah, demo itu juga dilakukan di berbagai benua di Asia, Australia, Eropa, hingga Amerika. Negara di Asia yang melakukan demo mendukung Palestina ialah Turki pada Sabtu 14 Oktober. Dalam video yang beredar, tampak masyarakat Turki berkumpul di Istanbul untuk menggelar demo massal solidaritas dengan Palestina di Gaza. Demo itu dilakukan di malam hari dengan cahaya dari masjid menjadi penerangan mereka. Aksi unjuk rasa kembali juga digelar di Pakistan pada Sabtu 14 Oktober. Demo yang juga terjadi di malam hari itu memperlihatkan lautan manusia di Peshawar. Kemudian negara Asia ketiga ialah Indonesia yang ikut berunjuk rasa pada Jumat 13 Oktober. Demonstrasi itu terjadi di titik 0 km kota Yogyakarta. Selain berdemo, ribuan warga juga tampak menggelar sholat bersama untuk mendoakan warga Palestina. Kemudian demonstrasi pendukung Palestina juga dilakukan di sejumlah kota di Australia. Warga berbondong-bondong memadati kota Melbourne dan Sydney pada Minggu 15 Oktober. Demonstrasi pendukung Palestina juga digelar di San Francisco, California. Terlihat warga mengibarkan bendera Palestina dan memadati jalanan di kota tersebut. Selain itu, negara Skotlandia juga berdiri untuk memberikan dukungan untuk Palestina. Sama seperti sebelum-sebelumnya, warga membawa bendera Palestina dan memenuhi jalanan di sebuah kota. Terakhir, demo di London, Inggris yang terjadi pada Sabtu 14 Oktober. Dalam demo itu terdapat 50.000 orang yang mengepung kantor Perdana Menteri Inggris Rishi Sunak.